It's Claylea. Welcome back to my channel. This is a little bit of a different video. I guess it's not different from every other video I do, but I don't normally post extra videos, and I literally filmed this yesterday. So, Apple came out with a new iOS, iOS 14, I guess you should call it update. Most updates aren't really big. They might have one big one every once in a while. Most of them are kind of smaller, fixing little bugs, things like that. But today, they came out with a really big update. This update is crazy. I feel like it was kind of made for like girls, like the aesthetic and making it just cute, like adding those extra what they call widgets that like basically don't do anything. They just look cute. Like I feel like it's such a girly thing, but I mean, it's obviously able to be used for anyone. Before we get on to that, make sure you guys subscribe down below to join my, what should I even call you? Comment down below. Give me a squad name. Give me whatever you think it should be. It was Claybay Squad, but I think it's time to switch things up a little bit. So anyways, also be sure to give it a thumbs up if you like these types of videos. Let's get straight on to the video. First of all, we're gonna answer a few questions. A lot of you have been asking why I have this phone, where my iPhone 11 went. Well, I'm here to answer. I've been commenting back to a lot of people that have been asking me that, saying that I would do a video later, and I decided to put that in this video right now since we're talking about iPhones. Moral of the story before we tell the story, obey your parents, kids. And they set rules for reasons. I would suggest you listen to them. Now, onto the story. We have many rules about the phones. My parents aren't super strict about it, but one of the main rules that we have is that you cannot bring your phone in the bedroom. And we have to turn it in at night, like whenever, before we go to bed. Sometimes we have curfews, it just depends. One day, I decided that I wanted to keep my phone past the curfew. It wasn't technically my curfew yet because I hadn't gone to bed. There were a lot of little like white lies, I guess you could say, or like lots of little like excuses like, oh no, it wasn't bedtime yet. Anyways, still disobeying. Everyone goes to bed. I'm in my bedroom calling a certain somebody. First of all, it was like 11:30 at night on a school night. I was not supposed to have my phone in my bedroom, and I was in the closet, which, first of all, I was in the closet because I liked to sit in there. I liked my privacy with this certain somebody, so I always went away from where Raquel was. Anyway, so I was in the closet. I wasn't like trying to sneak. My parents come in. It's like midnight now, and I am talking to this certain somebody. I was actually crying, which makes it even more horrible. And my dad opens the door and is very upset, puts out his hand and takes the phone. That was in January. It's September! My parents have tried giving me it back and I disobeyed again. That's why I do not have a phone. This right here is our home phone. I technically basically own it now because I am always using it and none of my other siblings really use it. Anyways, so that is why I do not have the phone. Kids, listen to your parents, obey your rules. I have not been complaining about not having a phone. Honestly, it's not that bad. Like, I still have this. We're all good with everything. Don't send hate to my parents or anything like that. I thought I would tell you guys that because you've been asking questions. Please don't send hate. I will just delete your comment because I don't want the hate. There's that. Now I've answered your question. Now you know why. Listen to your parents, and they have rules for a reason. They're trying to keep you safe. Now, technically onto the video. The new iOS 14. It's crazy different. As you can see, they have all these different types of things. The biggest thing is the widgets. That's what they're called. They've got Widget Smith. They've got photo widgets. They've got color widgets. You can get all these different types of widgets. Some can tell the time. They can do the moon phases. They can do the star phases. The weather, your screen time, all those different types of things in this small, cutified version rather than just the app and opening it. You can actually see it on your home screen without having to click on the app. It took me a little while to figure out how to do it. So basically you can see my home screen. It has all these different little photos. In the middle screens, I have this big widget and show it says love much. You can put different quotes, you can put different photos, you can put text. That I have right here. I'll be showing you guys how to do that in a second. Okay, so I figured I would show you kind of a little bit of how to create some of these different things. So I'm gonna show you kind of how I created my beautiful aesthetic home screen. Definitely not as aesthetic as a lot of other people I've seen do this. So kudos to you because it was kind of painful, not painful, but it definitely took a little while to find what I liked because I'm picky and all those things. So anyways, I figured I would show you guys a quick easy tutorial of how to do it. So, you can see in this middle, the fourth slide, you can see I've got my to-dos at the top. I have two little photo widgets, which are actually widget smiths, and then another photo widget. So I'm gonna show you guys how to make the to-do widget. So basically all you're gonna do, you're going to go all the way back to your first slide. It's like the settings version. It's kind of, it's just like the old iOS where you slid and then they had the search and all that kind of stuff. Yeah, anyways, then you're gonna look up Widget Smith, but you can see I have all these different small widgets, a lot of different cute photos, and then they have medium widgets, and then they have large widgets. So we're gonna be doing a medium widget. So you can see I have all these different ones, which a lot of them I already have on the phone because I've created them. Anyways, we're gonna be showing you the to-do one. What you're gonna do is you're going to click add a medium widget and it'll show up this default one. You're gonna click on it, just click on that thing, and then it shows default widget. You're gonna click on that, and then it shows you all the different versions you can do. They have the clock, they have the fuzzy time, then they've got the date and the time, or they've got the day and then the date. Then they have custom, that's where we're gonna be going. They have photo, photos and albums, custom text, and then blank. We're gonna be doing, and then they have a bunch of other ones, and like I mentioned, they have all these locked ones, which you actually have to pay for. So if you wanna do that, kudos to you. But we're gonna be going to the custom ones and we're going to be doing custom text. And then you can see there's a bunch of different little like slides on it. It shows style, text, font, tint color, background color. So we're going to be putting in our text, and I like to get kind of fancy, so I actually went to copy and paste symbols, which is like a website, and I copied and pasted the stars. This one I'm just showing you just the default stuff like in your keyboard. And then I put to do, and you can add whatever you need to do on there, or you could even add like quotes. I'm just showing you a to do. I found this from another YouTuber and I thought it was really cool that she added the to-dos, because I feel like for me personally, I've mentioned this in other videos, I love to-do lists. They seriously help me. So I am doing a to-do list, and then you can go to font and you can wrap, you can do lots of different styles. They have 9 different styles, and I of course am gonna go for the New York one because I just feel like it's cute and aesthetic. Then you can go to tint color. You can change the color of like the background of it. You can see my theme is black and white and then creams and pinks. So I am obviously going to go for a pale pink, or I'm gonna go for the cream one. And then you can also scroll down further and they have border colors. So on this specific widget, I actually added the white border color, kind of just to differentiate it from the other ones. You're gonna save it to a name that you want so you can remember that. Then you're going to press on your home screen, kind of just like the other update, just like you're about to like delete one of your apps. And then you are going to click add at the top left corner, and you will add a medium-sized widget, and then it'll add one. You'll click on that widget, and then it'll show another widget. You'll click on that, and then you'll scroll down to the one that you want, whichever, whatever the name is. You can see right here, it kind of shows you. That's how you add the medium ones. That's how I made the to-do one. And that's actually exactly how you do all the other ones. You can customize, you can do a photo, you can do a certain date, or the weather, or like I said, the moon phase, or the stars, which is actually really cool. I feel like that can go with aesthetics as well, like the black and white aesthetic I have. So yeah, you can find these photos off of Safari, off of Instagram, whatever you want. You just find a photo. It doesn't relate to the widgets or anything. I honestly looked up on Pinterest just certain aesthetics. You guys can go and follow my Pinterest because I made a specific board just for this. It's called the iOS 14 Aesthetics. That is what my board is called. Go and check that out. That has some of the photos I actually have on this iPhone and a bunch of other ones that I found. They kind of go with certain aesthetics. We've got the creams, we have like brighter pinks, we've got a California style because your girl is loving and obsessed with California at the moment. So I kind of went over that. I hope that was not too confusing. You can honestly play around. There is also photo widgets, which I personally don't exactly like because you can't actually edit which ones you want. You just add in a bunch of different photos and it kind of plays those on shuffle. You can make it play it on shuffle or you can click never, but it kind of gets a little bit weird. You can see right here, it will change every 5 minutes or it won't, and they're both the same as you can see. So anyways, you can use that if you want, but I personally love the Widget Smith, which is the main one. Go and check that out.